Now, Sonic Dream's collection caught my attention for its sudden internet sensation and its familiar name. A Sonic game that's received universal praise. Now there's something you don't see anymore. It didn't take me long to figure out why. This is Sonic porn, and nothing else. First, let's start off with noting that the resolution options do not properly adjust themselves to fit the screen. I'm sorry, but if you have a 920 by 1080 screen, you should expect the window to match the screen and not go over. The first minigame is called Make My Sonic. In here, you can change the body sizes and color of your hedgehog, then select a name and take a picture. It's extremely basic and done horrendously, as you aren't given any sliders or color palettes, just a button to keep pressing until you found your limited size and color. Same goes for the name and background color, limited and random. You can then choose to tweet or save your photo, if you want to. Waste of opportunity is what I would describe this minigame. Next is Eggman Origins, which is literally nothing. Okay? Of course, this brings us to everyone's favorite part of the game, Sonic Movie Maker. Here you are to film 6 seconds of each scene with the given objects and camera. This is where I dubbed the game as Sonic Porn Simulator, because the filmmaking aspects of this minigame are extremely weak, and what this activity really shows are some edgy Sonic fanfiction skits. You cannot keep characters still or animate anything yourself. Picking up objects could also take up most of the screen. You can choose to add dialogue bubbles to the scene, but even that has strict limitations. If you're looking to make a Sonic movie, you can pull all of this off and more on Gary's Mod. No, what you came here for is the edginess. And boy, will you get what you came for. Except you could probably find what you seek to be on DeviantArt or YouTube without the cost of memory and patience. So really, there's no point for this mode whatsoever, whether you have a creative and or dirty mind regarding Sonic. There's not even a lot of stages to go by, so what you see is what you get. You can tweet your 6 seconds worth of Sonic porn at the end of each stage, if you want. There is a short story in this minigame, but it's really just a lot of Sonic sex. The last minigame is a virtual reality simulator called My Roommate Sonic, where you are to tickle Sonic in the naughty bits until you turn him on. And that's it. So is this game the redemption for the Sonic franchise? Nope, not at all. Does Sonic Dream's collection deserve the internet sensation that's received? Nope, not at all. I am not going to rate this one, for I am too scared to think about it. So we are done here. Bye.